I was on the central line, and he was on the Bakerloo. Oh, dear.
Sorry I'm late, lady. Alarm didn't go off. The train was late, and I had to take the kids to school.
I'm sorry, Lance. I don't believe you.
No, it's true. I vividly...
Lance, I woke you up at 7 o'clock this morning. You're coming by car, and you ain't got any kids.
Oh, yeah, right. Oh, I remember. I had to go to the vet to get a prescription for the dog. I had to drop my mum off at the bus stop, and there was an air traffic controller's dispute.
No.
No. I'll start again. The traffic on the M25 was diabolical.
Never mind, Lance. Here, come and have a look at this.
What?
This. Right, now stop arsing about and give me an hand with this motor. She'll be in to pick it up at lunchtime.
All right. Oh, blimey, look, she's got a bald tyre in.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, never mind. The other three are all right. We'll have them. Better take the wing mirror off as well. Her eyesight isn't that good. I shouldn't think she uses it much. Going handy on your helmet in, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I'm thinking of selling my helmet in as it goes. How much for it and I'll get for it?
Well, I was talking to that fat bloke down the pub last night. Nice bloke.
Yeah, nice bloke. Nice and fat.
And he said... Blimey, it's fat, isn't it? Anyway, he reckons your helmet in's a classic car now.
Well, he should know, you know, like fat people know a lot about motors, don't they?
Oh, yeah, he's well up on motors. He said if you want a part exchange, your best bet at the moment's your German car, which is an interesting opinion for a fat bloke. Imagine that on top of you, you wouldn't be able to breathe, would you? Anyway, Alvin, right, he was down a pub and all. He don't like German motors, he reckons they don't hold their value. Mind you, they're very good in queues, you know, push their way to the front.
What did the fat bloke think?
He prefers your Italian sports car. Blimey, imagine him on the bog. No wonder the seats are all busted down the pub. I bet he has to take someone with him to catch his bum when he undoes his trousers. Anyway, Alvin, right, he don't like your Italian class. He lost £500 on his Alfa Romeo the other day.
Oh, I bet that fat bloke wished he could lose £500. Blimey, the amount he sweats and all.
Well, they do sweat more than us, don't they, fat blokes? It's part of their culture. Right, here he comes now. What's he doing here? Blimey, look busy. All right, Lee, Lance.
Hello, fat bloke.
Bob down at pub, bro. Mind if I use yours?
Oh, we haven't got one.
It's engaged.
I'll use the one down at Caff. See you later.
See you, fat bloke.
See you, fat bloke.
Nice bloke.
Nice and fat.
Yeah. Now, are you finished doing this door mirror yet?
Yeah. Sun door?
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah.
What was that?
Some bloody sitcom. Life begins at 40. Try telling that to John Lennon. Right in there.
Christmas card?
You're not sending a Christmas card, are you?
Just the one. Queen Mum, as usual.
Oh, fair enough. What did it say?
I've written her a little poem. Hmm. Wipe that radiant smile off your face, you old witch! I couldn't get it to rhyme, though.
I hate poetry. The only poem I've got any time for is Death the Leveller. What?
I see number 43's curtains have been drawn for the week and there's a massive build-up of milk outside her door.
I reckon something's gone tragically wrong there.
Not as tragically wrong, though, as him next door.
Teach him to use a fly, mate.
Right through the lead.
Next door's funny.
At a time, yeah, but not anymore, it ain't. His grass is growing out of control. It's sticking through our fence.
Is it?
I saw his wife in the garden yesterday. I said to her, Oi, snap out of it. Get your bleeding grass cut. It's been dead 3 days. She didn't see me, though. I was hiding behind the fence.
When's the funeral?
Today.
Good. And I ain't gonna burn him or bury him.
Up the chimney.
Yeah, that's how I'd like to go. have me ashes scattered in the old back garden when her next door's got her washing out.
Take her weeks to get you out of her niggers. Here, do you remember that time they asked us to feed their cat while they was away?
We fed it all right.
Get a rock violin down the very messy. And then they rang up to say they was looking forward to seeing their little pussy again.
Lucky we got it all on video.
Talking of dogs, I reckon ours is on his last legs.
Yeah, I shall miss him. He's good entertainment. Particularly since he went blind and we started moving the furniture around.
Excuse me?
Who's that? Bob and Job Week.
Snivelling little git, why can't you do it but nothing?
Can I go now, please? I've been here 2 weeks.
No! Start on that loft conversion. I ain't giving him a bloody silly one. Nothing. And don't forget to eat that dead course neither. Yeah.
Do your tongue of that
and stop being so small.
Oh. I'm in no stairs. Snivelling little git, I ain't that baiting pal.
Fancy popping round next door while she's still at the funeral and turning off the heating on her tropical fish tank.
Bloody bigger. So, Charlie tells me you're a war correspondent.
Yes, yes, that's right.
Yeah. Though, obviously not at the moment, because you're here.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've just been in the Gulf.
Really? Mm. Gosh. Wow. Why?
I've been covering the build-up of troops in Saudi.
Oh, yeah, yeah, of course, yeah, yeah. Must have been bloody hot out there.
It's a desert.
Yeah, of course, yeah, yeah. Yeah, of course it is, yeah. Yeah. Hosepipe ban, I expect, but... gotta obey the law, very important, yeah, yeah. Tell me, something I've always wondered about you war correspondent chaps, do you wear a hat?
Occasionally, yes. Actually, at the moment, I'm more likely to be wearing a chemical warfare suit.
Really? Chemical warfare suit, eh? Gosh, do you get these off the peg, or do you have a chap who runs much?
The standard army issue.
Oh,
they
yeah.
prevent chemicals attacking the nervous system.
Right, right, yeah, yeah, jolly good, yeah. Got to be careful of chemicals, haven't you? Chap at school burnt his finger on a Bunsen burner. Bloody murder, I tell you, really was, yeah. Oh.
It's not quite the same thing.
No, no, it wouldn't be, no. No, of course not. No. So they don't have Bunsen burners out there?
No, not at all.
Well, there's one less thing to worry about. Phew.
The Iraqis prefer mustard gas.
Really? The Iraqis are out there as well, aren't they?
It's them against the world.
Oh, well, bloody good luck to them.
Well, they're against us.
Oh, well, I hope the blighters come a cropper then. Yeah. Tell me.
Look, I'm sorry, I've got to go.
Oh, so you're not staying?
No, I've got to catch a plane.
Yeah, so you don't sail then?
Not in the desert, no.
Yeah, that's a pity, yeah, because got a bit of 42-footer down at Chichester. Me and some of the chaps going down the weekend, gonna suggest you joined us. Enormous fun.
Yeah, look, I'm flying to Baghdad tonight.
Oh, right, yeah. Baghdad's a bit far from Chichester. Is it?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Oh, well, maybe next weekend, then. Anyway, bloody nice meeting you.
Yes, yes, and you. What is it that you do again?
Oh, me, yeah. Foreign Office. Snore, snore. Bloody nice place.
Radio Fam, Radio Fam, Radio Fam, FM.
Mmm,
taste mongers. I'm just having a nice cup of tea. I love tea, don't you? Especially a nice cup. In the words of the old song, I like a nice cup of tea. It makes you think, doesn't it? Well, it makes me think anyway. And, talking of all things nice, here's me old mate Dave Nice, just back from his holidays in Greece and looking poppadabadobulous.
Rockadabadobulous to you, mate.
Looks like you got a chance to soak up some rays there nicely. Did you do a lot of sunbathing, mate?
Sunbathing morning, noon and night, mate. Took a young friend of mine with me, and every day it was togs off, oil on, and down on the beach for a spot of sunbathing.
I love sunbathing. I know when I'm on holiday, I love to sunbathe.
Did a lot of sunbathing, mate. You can't beat it, can you? Lying out there in the sun, sunbathing. But you know the great thing about holidays, apart from the sunbathing? Yeah, get a chance to catch up on all your reading. Did a lot of reading of books out there, mate. All for charity, of course.
Books are fantabulous, aren't they, mate? I don't know, they're sort of like films in word form.
You're not wrong there, mate. I read Oliver by Charles Dickens, the book of the film. None of the songs in there, but a bookmongers read, nevertheless. Some of the words he uses are quite phenomenal.
I know what you mean. Those old-fashioned pilchards, they really knew how to write down sort of what they'd been thinking about earlier.
Wise words, mate. Just look at old Shakespeare. All those plays from just the one guy, nobody to help him, and only an old feather to write with. Quite phenomenal.
I don't know, and what a brumungously megatastic contribution to English language, culture-wise, what with all that need-now type stuff.
Thou art. Not wrong there, mate. But that's enough chat from us old culture vultures.
Sure is, mate. I'm going to pop off home now, well, because, you know, that's where I live.
See you, Smashy. What a great guy, old Smashy there. Does a lot of good work for charity, doesn't like to talk about it. Right now, we're going to get down to a real classic. Messrs. Parkman Turner Overdrive with their interpretation of the Shakespeare play, Thou Ain't Seen Nothing Yet. Let's rock.
So, nicely, I forgot to ask you, did you do any sunbathing while you were on holiday?
Not really, mate. The weather was bloody awful.
Morning, boys.
That's a very good point, Mrs. Housekeeper. Because it is a good morning, a very good morning. And may I say, it's a very much better morning than any of the mornings we had when the member for Coldfields East Party was in.
That's all nonsense. Under a Labour morning, people used to get up whistling democratically.
Yeah, no. Yes, I'm sure they did. Now, what would you like for breakfast?
What's the choice?
Ah, well, you see, you said it yourself. You used the word choice. There is a choice. There is. And that's something that this Conservative government's given back to the people of this country after over 40 years of censorship.
For the vast majority of ordinary working-class breakfast-eating, Labour-voting people, there has been no choice whatsoever.
Well, the choice is porridge, bacon, sausages and eggs.
Ah, well, you see, I believe you mentioned eggs, Mrs. Housekeeper. There's a good Conservative breakfast.
What about black pudding?
Boiled eggs with plenty of soldiers.
I resent the implication that the Labour government would leave this country undefended at the time of a nuclear attack.
Now, if you disguise your ignorance and stupidity for just a minute... You would say that the facts of the matter are that under this government, my consumption of boiled eggs and soldiers has gone up by over 80% in real terms. Tremendous achievement, and my thinker goes to prove it.
Look, it'll all be cold by now. Do you want it or not?
Well, it's a very important question, Mr. Housekeeper, one that I fully intend to answer. Of course I do. Make no bones about that. But let me first say that the EEC... Absolutely typical of you. You bring your blinkered socialist dogma into everything. Well, I'm not going to let you. I'm going to ignore you. I'm going to ignore you completely. Of course I am. Well, I eat my breakfast here in front of me, and a very nice breakfast it is, too.
No, it isn't. And I'll tell you why it isn't, because there is no breakfast on the table. And there's nobody to make it for us either.
Yeah. Well, there's only one thing for it, then.
Regrettably, that is true.
We'll just have to go out into the kitchen ourselves, form a committee to look into this grave non-appearance.
I absolutely agree.
And I'll be chairman.
No, I absolutely disagree.
No, I must be chairman.
No, we must elect him democratically.
This is not a Stalinist society.
No, but it isn't democratic.
Mr. and Mrs. Slob.
What?
Would you like to come to the font now?
Why?
For the christening.
Well, we've got to come all the way over there.
I finished my pizza.
I'm afraid that it's a necessary part of the ceremony.
So It's necessary. Now, shut up! He's wearing a dress!
He's a bloody vicar. He's supposed to wear a dress. All right?
Now, Mr. and Mrs. Slob, I'm glad to welcome you here in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with the knowledge that your child will grow up in the true tradition of the Christian fellowship.
What's he on about?
The Bible.
Are the godparents present?
We're the parents.
No, the godparents.
She just told you, we're the parents. You deaf or something?
I mean, who's the godfather?
Marlon Brando!
Never mind. If you'd just like to hand me the child.
He's got it.
Oh, never. You had it lost.
Look, you've left it over there. Got fake?
I'm afraid not.
Oh. Nice dress.
There you go, mate. Mind that, it's probably shit itself.
Bless this child, O Lord our God, and accept it into your house that it may join your flock.
It's not a bleeding sheep, mate.
Unfortunately not. And what have you chosen as the child's name?
Elvis.
We are not calling it Elvis.
We are.
We ain't.
We are.
We ain't.
Why not?
Because Elvis is a boy's name.
Well, it's a boy, isn't it?
No. A bleeding girl.
Well, you might have told me.
We want to call it Frogmella.
What type of the name's Frogmella?
Exotic. It's exotic.
See, it's exotic.
I named this child Frogmella Slot.
Don't put it in the wall.
Oh, what are you doing? You're going to make her all soggy. Hang about. That's not Frogmella. That's a cake.
Well, where's a bloody baby then?
You must have left it in the boot with the pizzas.
I think you'd better come back another time.
Oh, look, just give us your instruction manual. We'll do it. Oh, no, I'll do it. You're
right. What about a middle name?
About Ashtray.
Ashtray's a boy's name.
Well, Goffman's then.
Yeah, I like that. It's exotic. Or how about Lothar?
Hey, do you want a cup of tea, our buddy?
I don't, I've just had one.
Hey, well, I'm making one. Do you want one or not?
Jesus, do you have to make such a fuss about it?
I'm not making a friggin' fuss about it!
Make a cup of tea or don't. Just get off my friggin' back.
Don't talk to me like that or I'll break your friggin' neck, all right?
Come on, calm down, calm down.
It's only a cup of tea we're talking about here.
Yeah, he's right, sir. It's only a cup of tea.
Yeah.
What do you mean, yeah? This is a cup of tea we're talking about here.
I know it's a friggin' cup of tea, don't I?
You obviously don't, do you? You don't know nothing.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
God. Yeah. You two breaking it. Look, what's all this about, Gary?
You keep out of it, Barry.
You telling me to keep out of it?
Are you asking me whether I'm telling you to keep out of it?
Yeah, I am. Hey, all right, you two, break it up, eh? What's going on here, eh?
You asking me what's going on here?
Yeah, I'm freaking out.
I'm going to burst it in a minute.
Oh, yeah, you just try it.
Kettle's boiled. Oh, great. See anyone?
Yeah. I do.
Look, don't start.
Give me your light.
All right, great. Tea, eh?
Yes.
All right. Me.
Just what the doctor ordered, eh?
Hey.
Pass the milk, sir.
You ordering me about?
Yeah, what about it?
Don't what about him, you or what about you?
Oh, all right.
Don't miss next week's edition of Breadside, in which Gary, Barry and Terry have an argument.
Oh, thanks. Let me just finish this bit. I don't want to leave a line.
Okay. So.
Only me?
Hello, Dad.
Just thought I'd pop round and have a look at your new place. I'm not stopping, no. Won't even take me coat off.
So, this your new house, is it?
Yeah, that's right.
Not very nice, is it? You don't want to live here. You want to live in Hendon, near me.
That's why we moved from Hendon, Dad.
Oh, you don't want to do that.
What?
You don't want to hang the coat up like that. What do you suppose he looks for when he's at home, eh? Hey, you want to use a coat hook in all its actuality. Oh, well, I'm off. I'm not staying. Have a nice cup of tea. What's he to do in there?
Painting.
Oh, you don't want to do it like that. You don't want to use a roller. You want to use a paintbrush. It's much quicker.
Oh, thank you. I don't mind.
What's going on here, then?
Pouring your tea.
Oh, you don't want to do it like that. You don't want to put the milk in first. You want to put the tea in first and then the milk. Go on, you'll have to make another pot now. What colour's that supposed to be?
It's pale blue.
Pale blue? Pale blue? You don't want a pale blue in a room like this. You want a misty buff or a mint sunrise or an oak funnel. Here, I'll give you an end. Hey, oh, just get this ladder. Now, I don't believe you wanted to do that, did you? Oh, dear. Oh, well, I'm off. Where's that tea?
Here you are, Dad. That's two sugars.
You don't want to do that.
You always take two sugars.
No, you want to let it brew for a while before you put them in. You'll have to do it again. Didn't want to do that. Is that an eggshell finish or a satin?
Eggshell.
Oh, you don't want an eggshell.
I mean satin.
You don't want a satin? Oh, yeah. Look at that shelf. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. No, it's all wonky. Oh, this one needs coming up a bit. I'll do it. You don't want to leave your washing up piling up like that, do you?
Hey! Is it? I am going out.
Just wait.
You don't want to leave now. You want to finish your job now, you started.
Dad?
Hey?
The next door neighbour's about to start mowing his lawn.
What? At this time of day? With his slippers on? I'll best go and have a word with him. Ah, well, love you and need you. You'll have to finish off without me, I'm afraid. Sorry about that. What a thing, this carpet up. Look, you've trodden paint all over it. You didn't want to do that. Why would you want to do that for? You didn't want to leave that ladder there.
Welcome.
I'm sorry, love.
Oh. It's all right, everything's all right. I said to him, you don't want to cut your lawn now, you want to wait until I'm moving.
What?
Oh, didn't I tell you? I bought the place off him. I'll be more convenient for you. Oh, yes, I'll be able to come round a lot more often, give you a bit of advice. Right, where should we start? Left door opens the wrong way, you want it to open the other way. You don't want a 60-watt bulb there, you want a 40-watt, don't you? You want to knock that wall down? Oh, and look at that shelf, it's falling all over the place. You want to fix that? Have a nice cup of tea. Only me!
No, it's not, no. This is 483-1917. No, it's not 483-1918. No, you got the wrong number. We're talking telephone numbers here. This is 483-1917. 191... Oh, no. Hang about it. No, you're right, yeah. It is 483-1918, yeah. Yeah, hello, Mum. Thanks. Bye.
What's she want?
Sue's saying thank you for her birthday present.
Oh, what'd you get her? Something nice?
Yeah, 6 cans of lager.
She like lager then, does she?
No. I could drink the lager and she could have the cans after, you know, make a necklace out of them or something.
That's a good idea, yeah. Anyway, how'd you get on last night then?
What?
You know, last night.
What?
Oh, for God's sake, Lance, last night, your date.
Oh, with Melania.
Melanie, Lance. She's called Melanie. Lance, you must have impressed her.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, come on, then. I want a blow-by-blow account. Describe everything that happened in obscene and graphic detail. Leave nothing out.
Well, first of all, we went to the pub.
Yeah?
Yeah, and I had beef burgers, chips and beans. 2 beef burgers, 27 chips and 104 baked beans.
Not that much graphic detail, Lance.
A couple of beef burgers, almost 30 chips and about 100 beans.
She must have been fascinated.
Yeah, she was.
Oh, look, Melonia.
Melanie.
Melanionia. 104 baked beans. Last time I brought a bird here, I had 125. 27 chips, though, I see, which is two more than last time. So what I've lost in beans, I've gained in chips.
So what happened after this riveting little conversation?
Well, then she said, did I want to go outside of her to the car park?
Oh, yeah. Did you go, eh?
No, I thought she wanted to beat me up.
So you didn't get anywhere with her?
Ah. Well, then I used my killer line, right?
Yeah.
It's all very well you going home, Melonia, but can I have 20p for my bus fare?
You don't have a lot of luck with ladies, do you, Lance?
Nah. No, I have problems with conversations and knowing what to say and conversations and talking and that.
You surprise me.
You couldn't give us a couple of tips, could you?
Well, you know, what you got to do is you got to, like, compliment them, ain't you? Right. Look, I'll show you, right? I'll be the bird, you be the you, right?
Nice overalls, I love you. Can I have 23 for my bus fare?
Well, mind your head, Lance.
What?
Birds, Lance, is 99% of birds are dying for it 99% of the time.
Huh.
Trouble is, you always get both 1%. All the others dying for it. Like that bird who came in yesterday, right? You could tell she was dying for it by the way she said, I'll come back for it later.
Talking about a car.
Oh, yeah? Well, how come she come back five times then?
Because you never mended it. Look, it's broken.
No. You see the news last night?
Yeah.
Julia Somerville?
Yeah.
Dying for it. Then that interview with Edwina Curry?
Yeah.
Dying for it. Then after the news, do you see the weather?
Yeah.
Dying for it.
What, Bill Giles?
On the other side, you daft kid. Look, here she comes now. You watch, right? She's dying for it.
Right. Is my car ready yet?
No, love. There's a slight problem.
What?
It don't work.
Right. You have it ready by this afternoon or I'm going to sue you. Do you understand? Can you get that into your tiny little mind? This afternoon and I'm paying the original quote. Nothing more. Get it?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
Dime me!
Pop Mungus, Tears for Fears there with Mad World. And talking of being mad, look who's just been brought in by the men in white coats. It's me old crazy bonkers mate, Dave Nicer. You just don't know what he's going to say or do next.
Morning, Smashy.
He's uncontrollable, isn't he? And I don't know, so what have you been up to, mate?
I've just been on a wearing daft shorts for charity weekend, mate. How about yourself?
Well, actually, mate, I've been down on my farm, and, you know, while I was there, one of my pigs gave birth to a litter. A litter of little piggies.
Pork-tastic, mate.
And I'll tell you what, mate, every single one of them's absolutely bonkers. Mind you, they'd have to be to get on the old smashy farmstead. I mean, you ought to see our cows.
I love cows, mate. They're almost like horses in cow form. But you know, seeing them little piggies come out of the big pig must have been almost like seeing new life coming from old life, starting all over again to be born type stuff.
Mate, I was gobsmacked. 10 of them popped out.
All those little piggies from just the one big pig are quite phenomenal. And you know, we need that kind of thing, if you don't mind me getting a bit serious for a minute, because things are looking pretty serious and, you know, things being born is, like, good for the future life and the hope that life will carry on in the future. End.
Wise words, mate.
Thanks, mate.
And tell you what, why don't we have a phone-in poll about the end-of-the-world environment pollution type stuff? I mean, what do you think? Should our areas of great natural beauty be allowed to grow naturally, or should we muck them up with sort of oil or crisp packets and mudguards or that kind of thing?
That's a difficult one, Smashy. So why don't you give us a ring? You know the number, and if you don't know the number, ring us up and we'll tell you.
Actually, mate, I'm taking a young friend of mine along to a charity event to conserve natural resources this weekend. Over 500 of us are going up in our helicopters, and we're going to drive round and round London in a flying situation all day long, and we hope to raise over £50 for charity.
Sounds mega-tastic, mate, and I'd love to stay in chat all day, but I've got to be making a move. This is Mike Smash saying ba 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 dang 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 ba 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 digga digga dang dang bye bye.
See you, Smashy. Good old Smashy there, yes indeed. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Old Smashy there, of course. What a great guy. Putting the world to rights there and...
charity.
Does a lot of good work for charity. Doesn't like to talk about it. And right now, do you think the world's going to end? I don't reckon it's going to end yet. In fact, I reckon we ain't seen nothing yet. Norda Bachman, Turner Overdrive. Let's rock. So, I'd love to come down to your farmstead sometime and see the little piggies.
Too late, mate. Packed them off the old abattoir this morning.
I love bacon, don't you?
Manage. Rush. Oh, superb pass by Rush there to Houghton. What do you think of that, Jim?
Where's my dinner?
I'm just cooking it.
What is it?
Takeaway pizza.
How do you cook takeaway pizza?
I don't know. You have to ask him in the shop.
You can't cook takeaway pizza.
I can. You put it under the grill.
What's that burning?
It'll be the box, probably.
Well, go and put it out, then.
No, I want to watch telly. I've had an hard day.
What you've done?
Omnibus edition of Home and Away. What's this, then?
Football.
Well, who's playing, then?
Everton and Liverpool.
Oh. Well, who's that in blue, then?
Everton.
Well, who's that in red then?
Liverpool.
Well, how come he's wearing black then?
Because he's a bloody referee, isn't he?
Well, I think he looks like a bloody vicar, huh?
What's he doing picking it up?
He's a lad to pick it up. He's a goalie.
Well, I shouldn't call it football then.
Oh, shut up!
I ain't said nothing. And it's still in the Everton half, and Rush now. What's he doing?
He's kicking the ball, isn't he?
Not that one.
Well, which one?
That one there. Well, I don't know. I keep bloody running around. Good night. Why don't I keep still? I can't keep bloody up with him. Where's the one I like? What's his name?
Bobby Charlton has retired.
Oh, how come he's retired then? I liked him. I'd give him one. I want to watch the snooker. Oh, I like that Jimmy White. He's got a cute little bum.
You're not supposed to be looking at his bum. You're supposed to be looking at the balls.
But he's wearing trousers. You fancy from TVAM, the one that does the weather.
Well, I've got to keep you on your toes, ain't I? Otherwise, you just let yourself go the seed.
I wouldn't.
Anyway, it's different for me. I'm a man. I'm a free spirit. I don't want to be tied down. Where's my dinner?
I'm home! When are you?
Oh, I'm in the kitchen.
What are you doing? Washing your smalls?
No. Drowning the kittens. Did you get it then?
Yeah.
Let's have a look.
Ha 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 ha! win.
£1 million. I hope you made them count it 27 times. Good. Who'd have thought 92 no-score draws would ever turn up? He handed over the cash then.
That bloke you ate off the telly.
Oh, Leslie Crowther.
Nope.
Addie Seacombe.
Nope.
Les Dawson.
Nope.
Teddy Wogan.
Nope.
This could go on all day, couldn't it?
Yeah.
Come on then, who was it?
Vice Chairman of Littlewoods.
Yeah. He's not on the telly.
Yeah, but you ate him, didn't you?
So come on then, what are you going to do with it?
I don't know, do I?
Well, how about a nice holiday in the Bahamas with a lot of naked women rubbing coconut oil all over you?
What do I want to get coconut oil in me cardigan for?
That's a point, yeah. So what are you going to do with it then?
I don't know. I've already written my replies to all the letters I'm going to get now.
Oh, right.
Yep. These are for the begging letters, these are for the family, and those are for the charities.
Oh, that's nice. Yep.
Shut off, piece off, and bugger off!
Very thoughtful.
Trouble is, it's very difficult to think of things that cost £1 million that won't be inherited by your children when you die.
Yeah. You could buy yourself a country house and burn it down.
That's a good idea.
Or you can get yourself a racehorse and shoot it.
Now, that's a very good idea.
Yeah, best of all, why don't we just burn the bloody lot of it?
Now, that is a brilliant idea. Nobody's getting a penny of my money. Go on, get on a bloody fire with you.
Here, look. New minibus for the old folks home.
Two kidney units for the local hospital. Oh, we forgot comic relief.
Children in need. Well, you'll have to stay in bloody need.
No, let me finish.
One of you ring the ambulance.
Well, of course I will, Mrs. Housekeeper, of course I will. Here's the phone here. All I have to do is pick it up and ring the ambulance immediately, quickly, with speed and efficiency. And that's what I fully intend to do. Thank you very much.
Oh, just a minute, Mrs.
Housekeeper. You'll get your turn in a minute. He says this, but he does nothing, does he? I mean, it'd be quite easy for him to pick up the phone and dial 999. But does he do it? No! Oh. Typical of the Tory attitude to everything.
No.
For God's sake, I'm going into labour.
Oh.
Well, Mrs. Housekeeper, you've chosen to go into labour, and that's your choice. It's a free country after all. But had you chosen to go into Conservative...
Oh, come on, Jack. Under this Tory government, the average pregnant woman has had to wait a staggering 9 months to have a baby.
Waters are broken.
Oh, well, that should galvanise the member for Poshford into some action. He'll be across the area in a flash to privatise them. No, just shut up, Push, love, and let me finish.
It's a national disgrace!
Under the last Labour government, and the member for Coldfield East knows this quite well, Mr. Housekeeper, you didn't have any waters to break. And why was this? Because you were tied up in a sea of bureaucracy, willful mismanagement, red tape. A young conservative.
A young socialist. Here, get your camera as the photo opportunity here.
No, I should be the first to have my picture taken with the baby, of course I should.
No, oh, he doesn't want a big wet kiss from you. He wants a nice, decent, ordinary working class kiss that's been democratically approved by Congress.
No, he doesn't.
You should do, don't you, little comrade?
Oh, look at his lovely conservative
boy. Oh, look at his little socialist red chin.
Evening, sir.
Evening, sir.
How are we?
Reasonable. Yourself?
Reasonable, too.
Good. What are we driving at the moment?
Ah, a bit of a Rover 416 GDI twin cam 16 Velva.
Talking little engine, isn't she?
Yeah, she pulls off quite nicely.
left a Porsche 911 Carrera for dead at the lights outside the Fox Revive this morning. So, what particular beast are we training road-wise currently at this moment in the space-time continuum?
911 Carrera, excellent braking system, proved invaluable this morning when some Burke jumped the red lights at the Fox Revive.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Dr. Watson. But do I detect the inimitable Jeff sense of humour rearing its ugly head here?
Indeed.
Tatty Valerius.
Begging pardon whilst admitting guilt for extracting the urine.
Still, pushing humour to one side for a moment.
Ah, surely.
I've got a bit of a Granada 2.9 gear saloon.
Reasonable. How about your dear wife?
Nova.
Likewise. I always say you can't trust her with anything else.
No.
You know my little equation. Reasonable motor plus wife equals death tread.
Amusing. Amusing. Must log that equation in the old memory bank.
Beam a guest. Oh, looks like you're running a bit low on the old four-star yourself. Top up, Jeff?
Wouldn't answer in the negative. Jeff, I'll have a drop of the unleaded malt with a couple of blocks of antifreeze.
Roger, will do.
And out.
Evening.
Day.
So, what are we driving at the moment?
What?
Shut up.
Sorry I'm late. I forgot to put my clock back last night.
Clocks didn't go back last night, Lance.
No, I forgot to put it back in my bedroom. I'd left it in the kitchen.
What was it doing in the kitchen?
I was timing an egg. It took 3 hours.
You know, sometimes, Lance, I wonder why I keep you on.
Well, you don't pay me nothing.
Oh, yeah, that could have something to do with it.
So when are you going to pay me something, then?
Well, I taught you all I know. What more do you want?
Yeah, but all I know is how to rewind a milometer and how to recalf treads on a ball tire with a penknife.
I just said I taught you all I know. Wish you a bit more like old Special Branch there.
Why is he called Special Branch?
Because he works for Special Branch.
Oh.
It's good wheeze, actually. A few of their chaps go up our pub. I told them you was a cocaine baron.
Oh.
They sent him down to stake you out. You know, he's undercover bloke. And they paid me £600 a week for cooperating.
Oh, right, yeah, good idea.
He's a good worker, too. Here, you watch this. Oi, you haven't stashed a dirty great load of drugs in the engine over there, have you, Mr. Big? He'll have that engine stripped down in 10 minutes. All the parts nicely labelled. Child of two will be able to put it back together.
Oh.
Here. Did you see that Twin Peaks on telly last night?
Yeah.
I mean, what a bloody hell's all that about, eh? It's just like a weird soap opera, isn't it? I mean, what a bloody hell's all that about? I couldn't believe it.
Couldn't believe it.
Mind you, it's not as bad as that other thing, that Trials of Life with David Attenborough. What's that supposed to be about? It's all animals, isn't it? What's the bloody point of that? If you want to see animals, you get yourself a dog. I can't believe it. Mind you, I tell you, it's not as bad as one programme, right? I don't know why they allow it on telly. I honestly don't.
What?
The news.
Yeah, what the bloody hell's that all about?
Exactly. I mean, it's all they do is show you stuff that's already happened, don't they? I mean, what's the point of that? There's nothing we can do about it, is there? I don't know how they get away with it. I honestly don't.
Couldn't believe it.
I couldn't believe it.
It's like, here, did you see the boxing the other night?
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, well, you didn't miss much, right? Because all it was just like two blokes hitting each other. I mean, there was no story or nothing. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and have you been down that new swimming pool they just built?
No.
No, well, don't bother. Because all it is, right, it's just like some big square hole full of water. I couldn't believe it. I got soaked. All right, go on, change all my clothes. I mean, what the bloody hell's all that about?
Yeah.
Like, and I went down the pub the other night, right? I can't believe it. It was just all blokes like drinking beer and having a laugh. I can't believe it.
People drinking beer and having a laugh down a pub?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't believe it, eh? I reckon we ought to go down a pub and check it out, see if it's really true, don't you?
Yeah.
Come on, it. Did you decoat the engine this morning, Mr. Big?
Not yet, Mr. Man. I'll have this aerial for we don't.
What do you want that for?
Oh, well, I've run out of coat hangers at home. I thought I might be able to knock something up out of it.
Kabunga! Yo, bitch, mum, doing the washing up? Chilling, man. I've got in with the wrong crowd.
Yo, bitch, Mrs. Carter, how's it going?
This is MC Dude and I'm Rebel Sky TV. We think we're young, black and disillusioned.
Hello, David, how's your mum?
Radical, man, pucker.
Oh, nice. Kevin, have you tidied your room?
You're not doing it properly.
I am doing it properly.
Kevin, are you deaf?
Yeah, I'm deaf, man, and he's deaf too. We're awesome dudes. What's for tea?
Fish fingers.
Bitching! Ow, bloody hell, Mum's in the kitchen, and the MC's really bitching. We're the kings of rap, and Mum is really crap.
Stop showing off, Kevin.
I'm not showing off for your information. I'm voguing.
Clean before your father gets home.
Uh-oh, bedlam, the deadled head dude. It's the super bear.
Have a cup of tea, please, Mrs. Carter.
No way! Uncle, nobody drinks tea in Harlem.
Ribena, then?
Yo, Ribena! Yes, please, Mum. Oh, I mean, slink out, Fox. Hit me with it presently, bitch. But first, I need some cat.
Pussy.
Oh, yeah, I mean pussy. You can't snap, can you, Mum? How come you live so long if you can't even snap? Bloody hell, Baldrick, mine's bust.
Shut up, Kevin, and watch Blockbusters.
Ow! Blockbusters? I don't like it anymore now I'm young, mean and black.
Hello again, welcome to the show. Yo, dudes, chillin' back. Take it to the max, cowabunga. Hit me with it presently.
Yo, Bob, my main man, bitchin' Blockbusters. Take it to the max.
Hello. I wonder if you can help me. I'm looking for a book called Fly Fishing by J.R. Hart.
Is this a joke?
Oh, no. No, I've seen it advertised on television. Fly Fishing by J.R. Hart. It must be very popular, because chap in the advert couldn't find it anywhere.
It doesn't exist. The book was invented for the purposes of promoting the Yellow Pages telephone directory.
Oh, really? How terribly dim of me. I'm most awfully sorry for wasting your time.
That's perfectly all right, sir.
So, do you have anything else by J.R. Hartley?
Look, there is no J.R. Hartley. He was just made up for the Yellow Pages commercial.
Oh, right. Right, well, I better have that, then. You know, a tinker, tailor, soldier, plumber.
Spy.
Yeah, probably spy as well. You get everything in there, don't you? Taxis, hotels.
You're talking about the Yellow Pages, aren't you?
Yeah.
Have you got that? No.
Oh, shame. You ought to. It's a bloody good read. Yeah. I tell you what, have you got that other book? What's it called? We used to do it in scripture at school.
The Bible.
Oh, I don't know. We were forced to read it by the Reverend Tubbo.
The Bible.
Do you know the Reverend Tubbo?
No.
Oh, shame. Bloody good bloke. Oh, he used to beat me every day. Eternally grateful to him for that, of course. Made me the man I am today. Yeah. So, do you have that?
The Bible?
Yeah, that's the chap, yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
We have the Bible. It is, in fact, the best-selling book of all time.
Really? Gosh. Someone must be making a pretty penny, eh? Who's the author?
It's the Bible. There is no author.
What? The mysterious J.R. Hartley strikes again, eh?
Get out of my shop, you pathetic, inbred individual.
Bloody nice bloke. For a swat, anyway. What have you said? Good God.
Bloody hell's all that about it? He's just thick. What's the point of that? I can't believe it.
I can't believe it.
Sorry, but I'll get it.
Hey, no, you won't. I get the door in this house. I've always got the door in this friggin' house.
Hey, it's my house. I get the friggin' door, all right?
No, it's not. That's my house.
Hey, no. Hey, no.
I can't.
What's going on here? Is somebody at the door?
All right.
All right.
All right. Hey. All right, sis, come in, girl. You're looking well.
Oh, Gary, the lecky's been cut off. They've got to cut me lecky off. What am I going to do?
Hey, Gaff, did you open the freaking door?
Do you want to make something out of it?
Yeah, freaking you.
Well, come on, I'm right. Come on, break it up, eh? What's all this about?
The repossessed all my furniture and the social stop me money I've got now for the kiddies.
Oh, yeah, sis. Look, I'll lend you some money.
Hey, you will not. She's my sister. I'll lend her some money.
Look, if there's any money to be lent, I'll do it. All right.
Not if I've got any say in it, you won't. Sod off.
You sod off.
You sod off.
You sod off.
Come on, you two. Break her up, eh? What's going on here, eh? Hey!
I don't know what to do. The dog's been arrested for nicking cars.
You keep out of it, you daft cow.
So, hey, don't talk to her. She's like that.
Hey, she's my friggin' sister. I'll speak to her how I friggin' like.
No, you friggin' won't.
You two, come on, now break it up. Let's talk this through. Everybody stay calm.
What's wrong,
Jack? Pregnant!
Ah!
Hi, Larry, from next door.
Hey, a little baby.
Oh, bless it.
Hey, you can feel him kicking. He's going to play for Everton.
Oh, no, I friggin' won't.
Oh, yeah. How much do you know about it, eh?
More than you do, dickhead.
Reading the obituaries?
Yep. You're dead, I'm not. You're dead, I'm not. Surely missed, not by me, you ain't.
Anyone famous?
Just some bitch who sung popular songs.
Good. I hate songs, especially popular ones. Mm. The only song I like's that one about that young girl who drowned.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, me darling Clementine, fell in the foaming brine and drowned it. Shut your right, you silly gal.
Would you mind being a bit quieter?
It's no use you telling us to be quiet, woman. We're both stone deaf.
Yeah.
Aren't we heard that? Yeah.
Cup of tea.
All right. 3p. Yeah, you like this book?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people die in it.
What's it called?
Pacific Naval Campaigns of World War II. Very informative. There's a bit here where an American ship sank and all the Americans went in the water.
Sharks?
Yep.
Any pictures?
Unfortunately not. You'll just have to use your imagination.
Go on, die, you buggers. Biscuit?
Yes, please.
10p.
They've gone up, haven't they?
Yes.
Yes, I enjoyed the war. Killed a lot of Germans.
Oh, yeah, Western Front.
Dorset.
And there wasn't any Germans in Dorset.
Not after I got at them, there weren't.
Advanced invasion party, wasn't they?
Nope. Prisoner of war camp. I guarded them on the farm. Buggers got hold of a whole lot of hand grenades. Bucket fulls of them. Lucky I had me gun.
Hand grenades, eh?
Well, they look like that from a distance. King Edward potatoes do, you know. Ah, well, back to me book.
What is it?
Agatha Christie, Murder on the Orient Express.
Murder?
Yeah. Very exciting it is. You don't find out who's done it till right the last page. That's the drama section ruined.
Here, shall we start sticking the pages together in the romance section now?
Yeah, what's that noise?
Looks like that Lavrarian's took a turn for the worse.
Oh, dear, yes. Looks like she's having difficulty breathing.
Yeah, well, maybe we better do something about it.
Yeah, good idea. Shut up! Don't you leave the bloody sign! Shut up! Yeah. You're telling us to be quiet, you bloody hypocrite!
I went to a library once.
Did you?
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. It was just books everywhere. All nothing but books. I wasn't quite left. I couldn't believe it.
I can't believe you went to a library.
No, I can't either, but I did.
One of my all-time favourite records of all time there, Bachman Turner Overdrive with You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet. Gotta be one of my all-time favourite records of all time, that. If you want to hear it again, don't worry, it'll be coming up in a couple of minutes. Meanwhile, I've got a bone to pick with you, Smashy. I was lying on the old sofa last night with a young friend of mine flicking through the old TV times, and I saw that you've got your own TV quiz show. You get that one quiet, didn't you, you old devil?
Well, you know, I always say, mate, it's not really my show, it's their show. You know, the sort of ordinary members of the public who take part in it.
Mm. I love the ordinary members of the public, mate. They're so, ordinary. Must be a hell of a lot of hard work for you, mate. What with that and your Radio Fab FM show and all the good work you do for charity that you don't like to talk about.
Don't like to talk about that, mate. But we do record 17 shows in a day, so that helps.
That's rocktastic, mate. Tell us again, what's the show called?
Welcome to Call Me Wanker. Please welcome your host, the Smash with the Cash, Mike Smash.
Hello, and top of the morning to you, and welcome to another edition of Call Me Wanker. You lot are bonkers. Great show lined up for you today, so let's have a look at our contestants, Wayne and Waynetta Slog from Enfield. Popper, Dabber, Dobulus, Wayne and Waynetta. It really is quite literally great to have you on the show. Now, you know the rules, there's the clock. You've got 30 seconds to call me Wanker, starting now.
Wanker.
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 Wanker. Wanker. Wanker. Wanker.
Don't help them.
Oh, you little wanker. Wanker.
Wanker.
Wanker. Wanker.
Wanker.
Wanker.
Wanker. Wanker. Wanker. Wanker.
Wanker. Wanker. Wanker.
Wanker. Time's up, time's up! And Waynetta is the winner, the lovely Waynetta. What a very popular choice, and
Megatown.
Waynetta, how do you feel about scoring a Megatastic 87 points?
Waynetta.
She's incredible, isn't she? And you know what that means, my love? That means that you've gone through to our cashmongous big prize round. Are you excited about that? Well, all you've got to do, my darling, is name any word in the English language beginning with the letter B. Off you go. That's B for balloon. Balloon a do?
Boo, bird.
Let's have a look at some of our prizes,
What
about a lovely holiday on the beach in the Bahamas? On a beautiful boat? What about the money? Don't forget the money. Lifetime supply of money that you can put in the bank. Come on, my darling, you don't have to hurry it. Come on.
Potato!
Can we take that? Oh, bad luck, Waynetta. Oh, dear. Sorry, my dear, but I'm going to have to be a stickler about that. Never mind, you did very well. If it had been up to me, I'd have given you all the prizes. You lot are bonkers. Bye. Keep them shuffling.
Enjoying myself, you know.
Hello, sir.
Hey. Hello, Gat.
How's it going?
Oh, sounds smashing.
Great.
So what did you get up to last night then, eh?
Hey, it was magic. I took this bird to the pickies, then went back to her place for a shag.
Oh, great. Who was it? Anyone I know?
Yeah, it was, actually. It was your girlfriend, Samantha.
Oh, great.
Yeah. She said I'm much better in bed than you.
Did she? Yeah, well, what a good score, eh?
Hey.
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 Hey. So what did you get up to last night?
You know, nicked a car, went for a joyride, and I smashed it up.
Hey, any good, was it?
Oh, it was sound, brand new. Actually, it was yours.
Oh, yeah. You want to watch it, you know, mate, nicking cars like that. You could get into a lot of trouble. Lucky it was only mine, eh?
Hey, you like it? I'm going to stop doing that. Thanks for the advice, our kid.
Hey, well, what a brother's for, eh?
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. All right, girl. All right, hey, look at this.
All right, girl.
And well, Bruce did the drinks on me.
Hey, sounds. Where'd you get all that money from?
Well, actually, I've just been out and sold all your records without so much as a buy your leave.
Mine's a lager and black, please.
Sound, girl. Could I have a cider and black currant, please, yes.
By the way, lad, I forgot to tell you, before I came out this evening, I burnt all your clothes for no reason at all.
Sound, well, these things happen, don't they?
Yeah.
Oh, and by the way, when I came in, I went into the box and I wrote, Terry and Gary are puffs.
That's dead funny, Daddy. You got a great sense of humour, that.
Well, I'm a scouser, aren't I? They do, though, don't they, though?
Do they?
Anyway, here's your drink, Terry.
Ah, cheers, Bat. Hang about. That's a tart, class. Are you calling me a tart?
Do you want the friggin' drink or what?
Don't talk to me like that, all right?
Come, Ed. Come, Ed.
You stay out of it.
Series of sketches with different characters in it. I couldn't believe it.
I couldn't believe it.
Hello. The video you're about to see has been classified 18, which means that it may contain strong scenes of sex and violence, which could be quite graphic. Viewers who are easily offended are warned that it may contain some very explicit language, which may frequently mean the use of sexual swear words, such as bollocks, wanker.
Fab-fantastic. That was the, Beatles, I like Beatles, don't you? With 8 days a week.
It's only 7 days in a week, mate.
Right, thanks, mate.
Don't mention it.
But I think you find that what the Beatles, I love the Beatles, don't you, were saying...
I don't
was...
care what the Beatles, I love the Beatles, don't you, were saying, mate. There's only 7 days in a week. Never longer, never shorter. It's the law. Right. Starts on a Monday, goes through to a Sunday with a Wednesday-Friday type stuff in the middle and the weekend at the end.
I love the weekend, don't you?
Me too, mate.
Right, well, one thing I do is that today is Tuesday, which is quite literally Tuesday.
I love Tuesdays, don't you, mate?
Certainly do, mate. It's one of the best between Monday and Wednesday type days we've...
It's the only between Monday and Wednesday time day we got, mate. It may not have the glamour and excitement of a Saturday night or the mournfulness of a Monday morn, but it's our Tuesday, the good old-fashioned, honest-to-goodness, down-to-earth, great British Tuesday. And if those Eurocrats, bureaucrats and other bureaucrats try and take our Tuesday away from us, they'll have to get past me first. And if they think I'm going to start my show, Chorno Doodle-Do and Gunton Morgan Mungus, they got another thing.
I don't think they are going to do that, mate.
Right, but if they did, it certainly would be a garlic mungus intrusion of
It'd be frog-a-dabba-dobulously bonkers, mate. Because what makes a nation is not its borders or its monetary system, no. It's radio stations, such as Radio Fab FM, and the people who work therein, such as you, Dicey. You are what makes Britain great.
Thanks, mate. And so are you, mate.
Because this European business really is getting out of hand. I mean, now we've got all these daft new countries and making themselves up and wanting to be part of Europe. And I can't keep track of them.
Well, there's Ruramania, Czechoslovakia, Hungerslavia, Mungerslavia, Oms, Toms, Tobermory, Orinoco, Bulgaria.
Whatever did happen to the Wombles, mate?
Good point, mate. One certainly worth making. What happened to the Wombles? Well, I'll tell you. There they were, underground, overground. A wobbling free. And then, no more, they were... Were they not here where they were type stuff?
Wobbling wise words, mate.
Thanks, mate.
I love the Wombles. They really were great in a sort of short programme before the news type way. And I think we've all got a little bit of the Womble in us, haven't we? And I bet you got a bit of the Womble in you, ain't you, Nicey?
Well, I do know the pet shop, boys, if that's what you mean.
Not really, no. In fact, I think it's time I was making a move because I'm taking over from Pip Schofield tonight in Joseph's coat. This is me, Mike, no stranger to charity, Smash. Arrivederci, doodle-doo.
Oh, readers ain't pet. All right, all you Europrats, listen to me. My name is Davenport Nice. And I'm a standing... Yes, Davenport. I'm a standing firm for Britain, for her Tuesdays, for her Wombles, for her Barkman, for her Turner, and most of all for her noble overdrive. You ain't seen nothing yet, Europoppers. Let us rock.
Nicey.
Mate.
Do you really know the Pet Shop Boys?
I know the quiet one, mate.
Roses, violets, all types of flowers. Take them in your mother's ass and stick them in a vase. Roses, violets, all types of flowers. Take them in your mother's ass and stick them in a vase.
Mate.
What?
I'm thinking of becoming a vegetarian.
You what?
Yeah, well, you know, it's like the animals and that and the way they treat them in the slaughterhouses. It's not nice and it hurts them. Yeah.
Have you been talking to a bird?
Might have been.
So you're going to become a vegetarian, are you?
Yeah.
Right, so what are you going to do with all them spare cows?
You want them all roaming around the place wild, do you? Wandering all over the road without any respect for the highway code? You want to be responsible for all those extra deaths, do you? Is that what you want? Because that's what'll happen.
No, I just thought... No.
It's hard enough trying to get served in a pub as it is without it being wall-to-wall freezings in the public bar and Aberdeen Angus in the snug. Is that what you want? Because that's what'll happen.
Cats don't go in pubs, though.
Yeah, but for the sake of argument.
Oh, right, yeah, for the sake of argument, yeah. Oh, blimey, that's terrible. I hadn't thought of that. All right, then. I'll eat cows, but no pigs.
I see. So you're going to let little piggy wiggies live, are you?
Yeah, I like piggy wiggies.
Right, so you can do without ham, bacon, sausage chops, spare rib, spam, loin of pork, leg of pork, belly of pork, pork scratchings, crackling and foot. Well, what do you think they made the balls out of?
Piggy wiggies.
Piggy wiggies. You go down the old Spurs on Saturday, the old ref trots out, looks under his arm, no ball. Oh, dear, sorry, lads, we can't play today because that stupid little sod down the flower stalls taught some hippie bird for a quarter of an hour and has come a vegetarian. Is that what you want? Because that's what that
means. No, I just thought, you know, it might be...
All the footballers out of work and the football commentators... No jobs? What are they going to do? They're going to have to set up flower stalls round here, aren't they? Before you know it, we won't be able to sell a single daff because Satan Greasy got them 5p cheaper right next door. He said, what do you want? Because this will happen.
Greasy wouldn't set up a flower stall next to a pub. It'd be too tempting for him to go in there.
Greasy won't be able to get in a pub. It's chock-a-block with your pissed up cows. Is that what you want? Because this will happen.
No, no, no. But there are some animals I will not eat.
Like what?
Snakes. Snakes, snails, worms, centipedes, you know, any animal of that particular type or breed.
I see, so you're going to give up all meat that's slimy and disgusting. Fair enough. I admire a man of principles, Lance. So, what do you want for lunch, then?
I'd pack some jellied eels and some whelks.
Mmm, lovely, yeah.
Good evening. I wonder if I can count on your vote this Thursday.
No.
Right. How about Thursday week?
There isn't an election Thursday week.
Right.
Which party are you from?
The one that Charlie's uncle's the candidate for.
Who's Charlie?
He's the nephew of this politician chap here. Very nice fellow.
What, Charlie's uncle?
No, Charlie. No, his uncle's a terrible rogue. Politician, you know. Involved in some massive property fraud, but mum's the word till after the election. No, still, he's giving Charlie and I 300 quid to do a few streets for him. Says he can't be bothered, doesn't like the working classes.
What party is he? Conservative? Labour?
Says Con here. Sounds like Charlie's uncle.
So why should I vote for him?
Knew someone had asked that. I think this explains.
Monster fancy dress ballooning bashes, champers and hampers at 2,000 feet, staggering to special.
Sorry, wrong name. Is there anything else you'd like to ask me?
All right. Where do you stand on the Maastricht Agreement and the whole Federalist debate?
Right. Is there anything else you'd like to ask?
Yes, are you committed to going into Europe?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah. Yeah, I know the snow's been a bit dodgy the last few years, but definitely going to give Maribel another whirl. A tree!
What about transport?
Charlie brought me here in his van.
You don't actually know the first thing about any of your policies at all, do you?
Well, I'm more conservative with a small C.
You're certainly something with a small C.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. I was a floating voter, but 5 minutes with you has certainly changed my mind. Frankly, I'd rather shoot myself, my family, and any of their pets than vote for your lot.
So I put you down for a don't know, then. Well, one other thing. Is the no in don't know spelt with a K or an N?
With a K.
Right. And how do you spell that?
K.
Right. As in the letter.
That's it.
Right. Oh, one more thing.
Now, look, I'll tell you what. Let's play a little game, shall we?
Okay.
I'll close my eyes and count to five, and you go away, and we'll both pretend none of this happened at all. All right?
Bloody good fun, yeah.
Right, I'm closing my eyes now.
Right.
One, two, three, four, five.
Good evening. I wonder if I could count on your vote.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Oh, you don't want that as the question? What is the capital of Peru? That's a proper question.
To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is
Lima, that is the answer.
Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows.
Oh, you don't want to suffer slings and arrows. If those slings and arrows coming at you, you want to get out of the way pretty sharply. You want to hide behind a nice rockery or an ornamental shrub.
Or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing, end them.
Eh?
To die. To sleep.
Oh, you don't want to die to sleep, you never wake up. You want to take a nice sedative, that'll set you off properly.
To sleep. Perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub.
Now, I do not believe you want to rub there, do you? You want to rub somewhere more easily accessible.
Will you shut up?
Shut up? You don't want to say shut up. That's not it, is it, eh? Oh, I see I'm going to have to come up here and show you how to do it properly, aren't I?
To be indoors or outdoors on a lovely day like this, that is the question. What is the capital of Peru? That is also a very good question. Whether to take up spray against outrageous greenfly. Or to take night nurse to sleep. To sleep. A chance to dream. Only you don't want to do that. What you want to do is rub the easily accessible spot with a soothing balm or ointment. Lima, that is the answer.
Great bit of rock and roll there, and I love rock and roll. It's drainpipe trouser-tastic. And that was Runaway there, the old Del Shannon song.
I like the bit where he goes, oh, wah, 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 mate.
I like that bit too, mate, the bit where he goes, the wah, 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 wah.
And I hear that old Del, wah, 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 wah. Shannon's making a bit of a comeback.
Well, he'll have about 6 feet to go, mate. He's a wah, 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 dead. Great shame.
Great shame.
Great shame. But what about this general election palaver, mate?
Oh, don't talk to me about the general election, mate. It's a load of old nonsense, isn't it? I mean, I had this bloke come round my house the other day. Vote for me, he said. All right, mate, I will, I said. Then 10 minutes later, another bloke turned up. He said, don't vote for him, vote for me. I said, why can't you two get together and make up your mind who I'm supposed to vote for? And I slammed my daft door and left him standing there on my potty porch of my mad mansion in Bonkers, Buckinghamshire.
Wise words, mate. Labour and Conservative, you can have too much choice.
Right, yeah. What about hanging, mate? Hanging. That's something these politicians are always banging on about, isn't it? Should we bring back a hanging?
Well, I think we should, but only for people who kill policemen
and DJs.
It would be a deterrent, mate. But anyway, what do you think about war, mate? Is war a good thing or is it a bad thing?
It's a bad thing, mate.
Right, war. I mean, what is it good for? Absolutely nothing.
Say it again.
War, what is it good for? Absolutely nothing. And I've got a solution to world war, mate.
Have you, mate?
I have.
Right.
Right. Instead of a fighting and an arguing all the time, why don't all the various different governments get together and sit round a big table and have a good old pop trivia quiz? And then whoever's the winner wins, and what they say goes. You be Yasser Arafat.
Right.
Right, so I'm Bob Mughouse. So, Yasser, you're not nervous, are you? I hope not. Right, and here comes your question. Who was the creative mastermind behind the Wombles and the Hunting of the Snark?
Mad Mike Bonkers Back.
Congratulations, Yasser, you've just won the Gaza Strip.
Mughouse Mungus solution, mate. But you know what? I've got a solution to a major world problem of me own. It's the Mike Smash Morning Show solution to world famine.
What is it, mate?
Sandwiches.
Well, ham or cheese?
That doesn't matter, mate, as long as they've got a little bit of pickle in them.
Right. Right. Anyway, I know which bloke I'd like to be Prime Minister, and there's three of them, Mr. Barkman, Mr. Turner, and the Right Honourable Sir Jeremy Overdrive, B.A.D. Phil, Fellow of the Royal Institute of Rock. You ain't seen nothing yet, nor Z. Let's go.
So, tell me, mate, are you going to be exercising your prerogative in one of those little booths tonight?
Not tonight, mate. No, I've got to go out and vote.
Dad, I just want to say whatever's passed between us, I'm still your son and you're still my dad. Maybe in the past I never took the time to tell you, but I'm telling you now that I respect you. I admire you. Damn it, Dad, I love you.
Brad?
Yes, Todd?
Just want to say, I admire the way you handle your dad. It takes a lot of guts to tell a guy you love him, and I respect that.
God, Brad, I love you. I love you too, Todd. Todd?
Bud?
I just wanted to say that I admire the way you told Brad that you admired the way he handled his dad. It's not easy to tell a guy you respect him, and when someone has the guts to do so, he earns my respect.
But it took courage to tell Todd that you respected the way he handled my dad. I just want to say that I respect you as my boss, but I love you as a human being.
Todd. Brad, it's your dad. On three.
Dad, it's Brad. On three. Yeah.
Yeah. God, I love you, Dad.
What is it, Brad?
It's Dad, bud. He just wanted to say that he admired the way I told you that I respected the way you told Todd that you admired the way he told me that I respected my dad.
God, that can't have been easy for him to say.
Guy. Hey, he's earned that love, Brad, and you've earned his respect.
And I respect that.
You guys are the best. And you know something else?
I love you. It's our client, Rod, for Todd.
Rod, Todd.
What's he say, Todd?
Ah!
stick them in the mud, wait until the springtime and watch the buggers bud.
Tulips, daffodils, snowdrops and crocus make a lovely picture. If your camera's in for focus.
Heads up, Lance, here comes old Mr. Turner.
Morning, Mr. Turner.
Hot enough for you, is it, sir?
Yes, I've come for my buttonhole.
Every day a fresh buttonhole, eh, Mr. Turner? I reckon you got yourself a fancy woman, ain't you? You got yourself a nice little lady tucked away somewhere, ain't you, old devil? I reckon I could learn a thing or two off you.
I know I could. How'd you get a bra off, Mr. Turner?
I reckon we could all learn a thing or two off young Mr. Turner. Eh, Mr. T?
Would you like to sit down?
Oh, no, please, I've got things to do.
Oh, I don't think you have you, sir? You're living in the past. I expect you don't even know where you are, do you, sir? Here's your buttonhole. They've gone up. They're quite expensive. £400. Only joking. Oh, you like a joke, don't you, Mr. Turner? No, they're 8p, same as usual.
Yeah, well done for not getting run over on the way here.
I expect you remember when there weren't any cars at all, didn't you, Mr. Turner?
No, actually,
or aeroplanes. I bet you never thought a thing like that would get off the ground. Flat, flat, flat. All the changes you must have seen, sir.
Like computers, eh? I bet you never thought a thing like that would ever get off the ground. Flat, flat, flat.
Expect you'll be getting your telegram for the Queen, won't you, soon, sir? How old are you now?
68.
Oh. Younger than I thought. Still, nice to see your haircuts back in fashion, sir.
Well, I have the money.
Oh, the things you must have seen. The old First World War, eh? Bet you got a few stories to tell about that.
I expect you got killed in the war, didn't you?
Actually, I wasn't born until 1924.
Oh, so... what memories you must have.
Bet you can't remember any of them, eh?
You been mugged yet, sir?
No.
Oh, don't worry, you will be.
Well, the time is getting...
Now, come on, Mr. Turner, you know time has no meaning for you anymore. It's a bit of a gamble for you putting on a long playing record, isn't it?
I expect you probably put your favourite track on first, just in case.
You live one day at a time, don't you, Mr. Turner? Except they're probably in a different order to the rest of us.
Yeah, like the Virgin.
Eh?
That's my favourite track.
Eight.
Yeah, I bet you're upset there's no wrestling on the telly no more, ain't you?
Oh, I bet you've had some complex operations in your time, ain't you?
I haven't had me adenoids, eh?
Well, it didn't work, did it? Now, here's your buttonhole, Mr. Turner. Oh, you've already got one. You forgot, didn't you, you silly old sausage? You keep us on our toes, Mr. T.
Please take my money.
No, 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 no. They've gone up. They're 400 quid.
No, it's a joke, Lance. The life you've led, Mr. T, I could stand here listening to your stories all day long.
Hey, cool, blimey, he took his time, didn't he? I thought he'd never go.
Took the iron legs off a donkey, that one. I thought he'd never shut up. Well, don't you realise some people have work to do?
Yeah, sad, really.
Strawberries, two for a pound. Stick them in the garden and grow out the ground.
Rust and vine, grow them all in a minute. Plant it in your garden and get out there and sit in it.
Oh, good evening and welcome to the show. We got three lovely fellas lined up behind that screen over there, waiting for some lucky lass to have a date with. But let's not hang around. Let's meet them. Aren't they gorgeous? Oh. Tell us who you're on, number one, and what's your name?
My name's Barry.
No, it's not.
It's a friggin' insult, man.
No, it's our Barry.
If he's right, our Barry. It's our Barry.
Oh, right, our Barry. Okay, let's meet number two.
Oh, it's our number two.
What's your name, Chuck?
It's our Chuck. It's our Gary.
All right, let's meet our number three.
Our Terry Arcilla from our Liverpool.
All right, well, I think they're all gorgeous. Anyway, we'll see you later on. It's Tra for now. See you then. Well, now we get to meet the gorgeous Gail. We're going to meet her now. She's going to have a date with one of them fellas. So here she is. You're lovely too, aren't you? What's your name?
Charlotte.
Oh, Charlotte. and you're an investment analyst at a merchant bank.
Yeah.
What are your hobbies, love?
Renaissance painting and early English church music.
Oh, well, what are you looking for in a fella, love?
I like a man to be good looking.
Yeah.
Stylish. And with a good sense of humour.
Let's have the first question.
Botticelli's ideal woman was Venus. Who's your ideal woman? Number one.
Ah, mum.
Number two?
Ah, nan. Right. You saying our nan's better than our mum?
Are you saying our mum's better than our nan?
Hey. All right, calm down. Calm down.
Nan, you're forgetting someone.
Like who?
Our nan's mum, gran.
Are you saying our nan's mum's gran's better than our nan or our mum?
Yeah, hey? I might be.
Yeah,
come on, calm down, sit down, come on, calm down.
Let's have question number two.
Got a cup of tea? Come on, sit down.
Number one, what do you look for first in a woman?
A purse.
Number two, what would you say to me after a romantic evening together?
Get dressed, love. Your taxi's here.
I think we'd better go on to the next question, Charlotte.
Number three. I like to be taken out on a date by a boy who lays on flowers and champagne.
Ooh, champagne, I like that.
How do you take someone out?
I nut him, that'll take him.
Now, you smack him with a bottle, that's the way.
Now, I'd run you over with me van, love.
I don't think that's what Charlotte's question meant, actually, fella.
Are you saying our Terry didn't understand the question?
Yeah, no one calls our Terry Tick.
Hey, who are you calling Tick?
I didn't call you Tick, you dickhead.
Well, will she go for number one, who's got a moustache and is rather violent? Or number two, who's rather violent and has got a moustache? Or number three, the moustachioed violent one? The choice is yours.
I think they're all gorgeous, but it's not me that has to choose, is it? So come on, Charlotte, which one are you gonna choose?
Well, I'm sorry. I can't choose any of them. They're all rude, ignorant scousers.
Are you saying there's something wrong with coming from Liverpool?
No!
But well, come here, do you want a curvy kiss or what?
Oh, I'm glad I didn't come in on the M25 this morning. There's 10-mile tailbacks causing 4-hour delays, apparently.
Oh, you didn't want to come in the M25 this morning. There were 10-mile tailbacks causing 4-hour delays.
Shit, didn't come in on the M25.
You didn't want to come in on the M25. That is what I am saying.
And I'm saying I didn't.
And that is what I am saying.
What?
That you didn't want to do that.
Do what?
Come in on the M25.
I didn't come in on the M25.
You didn't want
to. I didn't.
And that is what I am saying. You didn't wanna. You wanted to come down the M11.
I did.
And come off at Walthamstow.
I did.
Thus avoiding the roadworks at Leytonstone.
I did.
What I am trying to say to you, if you would just listen for one moment and try to take on board what I am attempting to say to you, is that on no account did you want to come in on the M25 this morning.
I didn't. I came in on the M11 through Walthamstow, avoiding Leytonstone.
You didn't want to come through Leytonstone.
I didn't.
You didn't want to.
I didn't.
You wanted to come down the M11.
I did.
You didn't want to come in the M25.
I didn't come in on the M25.
You didn't want to.
I didn't.
You didn't want to.
I didn't.
You didn't want to.
I didn't.
You didn't want to come in the M25.
I didn't come in on the M25.
You didn't want to come in on the M25.
I didn't come in on the bloody M25, did I?
You didn't want to come in on the M25. You didn't want to come in on the M25. You didn't want to come in on the M25.
I bloody didn't! Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to shout. It's just... I didn't come in on the M25.
Didn't want it.
Maureen, get a bit busy down here, my love. Evening, gents. What can I get you? Half pint, short?
Come about the fight.
Oh, right, yeah. Last night, eh? That Eubank. Quaw, he's got a punch on him, hasn't he? Oh, no, I don't mean Eubank, do I? No, no, the other fella. One with a lisp. What's his name? Eubank.
About the fight in here tonight.
Oh, right, I remember now, yes, right, yes, of course. Right, so you gave me a tenner?
No, just get the landlord, will you? Leslie Norris, he's the one who called us.
Leslie Norris? Oh, no, he's the old landlord, no. Hey, down in Chichester now. Oh, no, tell a lie, no, it's me.
Well, you just tell us what happened, Mr. Norris.
What happened was John came. No, it wasn't John, it was Terry, Bob. Bob. Yeah, Bob came, one of the regulars, he came in. No, he's on his way out. Come to think of it, he didn't come in at all, did he? No. No, he hasn't been in for weeks, Bob. He's living in Australia now. Canada. He's dead. That's very sad, yeah. I'll try and get him on the phone for you, if you like.
Who actually started the fight, Bob, Terry or John?
Brian.
Where did the fight start?
Right, in the games room.
Where's the games room?
Just round the corner, you go past the gents, through the door, turn left, down the end of the road, over the traffic lights, take the A3327. It's about half an hour door to door.
The games room.
Oh, the games room. Oh, I do beg your pardon. I thought you said wantage. No, the games room. You want the B2217, is it?
Could we just stick to the point?
And what's that?
The fight.
Oh, right, yes. God, silly me, eh? You know, sometimes I think I'll forget me own... No, it's gone.
So why did John hit Brian in the first place?
Ah, well, you see, it was all a misunderstanding about his wife, you see, yeah. You see, I said to John, I see your wife's been having a little sex with Brian, only I didn't mean sex, did I? I meant chat. I'm always getting those two the wrong way, right? The round way wrong, the right way round, the wrong way round the roundabout, take third exit, the B2 turns 17, go straight through. Whoa there, Leslie, what are you going on about, boy? Oh dear, right, start the game. You gave me a tenner.
No. So John thought Brian was having sex with his wife.
Really? Wait till I tell Brian.
I think Brian already knows he's ended up in hospital.
Oh, well, you got a laugh, ain't you?
Laugh?
Well, it's important to keep your sense of smell, humour.
Look,
perspective.
Look, just tell me John's surname.
John.
Yes, John.
John Smith?
John Smith.
Certainly, officer. Constable Sergeant. One body John coming up. Have you good lady wife? Sorry, father.
Look, I don't want a drink.
Best way for the old bill to go, eh?
Could you just give us a simple, straightforward description of John?
He's a small chap. About 6'4", you know. He's got eight legs, eats flies, lives in the corner, frightens the wife. Oh, no, that's a spider, isn't it? He's bald with long hair, clean-shaven, moustache, wearing a red, yellow, white, black, blue shirt, and always carries a newspaper under his arm. Oh, no, I don't mean a newspaper, do I? No, that'd be ridiculous. No, a rabbit.
So, we are looking for a tall, short, bald, hairy man with a red, yellow, blue, black, white shirt with a rabbit under his arm.
Well, good luck.
Good night, Mr. Norris.
Good night, Poirot. Inspector Morse, Dixon Adoption. Love me, darling. Lovely they are. Nearly as lovely as you. Match your eyes, they do.
What do I do with them? Do I need to deadhead them?
Fucking deadhead my buds anytime you like me, darling. Four looks like rain. But put your umbrella up, love.
Yeah, she can put my umbrella up anytime.
Lovely girl.
Lovely girl. Whoops, Marge, don't step in that puddle.
Of course she can step in my puddle anytime she likes. Lovely
girl. Lovely girl.
Ah, look at her. Just crossing over the road and going into the bank without a care in the world.
Yeah, she can cross over the road and go to my bank without a care in the world any time she likes.
Lovely girl.
Lovely girl. I think she works in there, you know, behind the counter.
Oh, she'd work behind my counter any time she likes. Lovely girl.
Lovely girl. She can handle my small business account.
She can extend my credit facilities.
She can ask me if I wouldn't mind having a quiet word with the manager.
She can help me make a withdrawal any time.
She can borrow me a pen through the little wiggly drawer because I forgot mine any time.
She can stamp my stuff any time she likes.
Yeah.
Lovely girl.
Yeah.
Four, I'd give her one.
You what?
Said I wouldn't mind doing it with her.
Eh?
Well, I wouldn't mind sleeping with her.
Oh, I don't get it.
I would like to have sex with her.
Nah, you completely lost me now.
Right. Well, I wouldn't mind her polishing my wok.
Oh, right, now, I'll get it. Yeah, she can polish my wok any time.
Well, she can rummage through my wardrobe.
She can wash my spud.
She can rid of my bacon.
She can leave from my wooden boxes.
Oh, lovely girl.
Lovely girl.
Lovely girl.
Lovely girl.
Ow!
That's it, Mrs. Slaughter. Very well.
Look, why not? Is it on? Is it working?
I don't know, do I?
Look, you're not taking this at all seriously.
Come on, man. Push down, dear. Push down.
I am smoking a fag.
Are you having contractions, Mrs. Slob?
I'm having a bleeding baby, not a contraption.
Oh, it's on. Here, hold this a sec, will you? The Magic of Childbirth 2 is a sequel. Directed by me, Orson Slob. Take one. Let's hope something goes wrong, eh? We send it to Jeremy Beadle.
Try tripping the doctor up.
Perhaps you could just encourage your wife with her breathing.
Oh, right. Breathe! Breathe! Breathe!
Sponge! Sponge!
All right,
breathe.
Love, all right, a sponge nurse. Come on, love.
Here, what are you doing? Here, darling, sponge cake.
Thanks, love.
Here we go. All right, push down. Push down. Not you, Mr. Slob. Could you just encourage your wife, please?
Hurry up, Wayne. The film's probably running out.
Well, that's good. At least it looks as though we won't be needing to give you a cesarean.
But I want a caesarean!
What is a caesarean?
It's a type of fancy cake, isn't it?
Oh, what's that?
That's the baby. The head's come out. Well done, you're doing fine, Mrs. Slob.
Mm. Oh, yeah, why not? It's got a little head. All right, mate. Do you want a fag? Holy hell!
What is it?
It's a bleeding baby, isn't it?
Oh, is it a boy or a girl?
What am I supposed to know? Oh, second thoughts, it's a boy. What's more, it takes after its father. It's absolutely...
Mr. Slob, it's a girl, and that's the umbilical cord.
Reminds me, I must take that jumper back to Benetton. Could you film it for me, please? I want to do a bit of a family close-up.
Oh, she's lovely. All warm and wrinkly like she's come out the oven. She looks just like her name.
Oh, what's her name gonna be?
Spud You Like Her.
It's not Spud You Like Her. It's Spud You Lick Her. It's exotic.
phantasmagorical. That was KLF there with a song about some very old moo cows. And you're listening to me, Mike, no stranger to Charity Smash, saying thank Crunchy, it's Friday. Thank Crunchy for Radio Fab FM, and praise be to God on high for me old mate Dave Nice. Watch a nice
afternoon smash.
Quite literally, mate. Hello-dee doodle doo.
What have you been up to? Anything interesting?
Excuse me butting in and sort of interrupted type thing, mate, but what's this sign here? Dave Nice, Radio Personality of the Year.
Oh, no, how embarrassing. I told them not to bring that in.
Have you won an award, you old scoundrel?
Well, mate, I've been voted Radio Personality of the Year, but I'd rather not talk about it, if that's all right.
Right, OK, mate, I won't say another word. So here's Simply Red with...
No, mate, I'd rather you just didn't say another word. He's being awarded Radio Personality of the Year. Doesn't mean a thing, although, of course, there is only one person awarded the Radio Personality of the Year award each year. This year, it just happens to be me, who's been voted Radio Personality of the Year.
Right, well done, mate, and if you'll forgive me for talking about it for just a mo, I'm only glad it was you that got it, not me.
Thanks, mate, but I really wish you'd won it.
Oh, no, mate, you really deserve it.
Not as much as you, mate.
Many thanks.
Sorry that you weren't there, Smashy, because you would have been joining when I was voted Radio Personality of the Year. You really would have loved that, mate. Where were you, you old scoundrel?
I'm sorry I couldn't make it, mate. I had to pick up the OBE. So here's... What, mate?
You're pulling my leg, aren't you?
No, I've got an OBE. I've probably got it in recognition of all the great work that I do for charity, which, you know, I don't like to talk about. But, you know, I'm only sad it was me that got the OBE, mate, not you.
No, mate, you deserve it.
Not as much as you, mate.
No, mate, you really do deserve it more than me.
Yes, you're probably right. Though I do think that being Radio Personality of the Year, such as you are, is far more important than being quite literally Sir Mike Smash OBE.
No, mate. An OBE isn't the same as a knighthood.
Oh, did I forget to tell you, mate? I got knighted as well.
Knighted as well? Caramba!
So, just the one award for you then, was it, mate?
Well, no, actually, mate. I do have another award, probably the most coveted award in share business.
Really? What's that, mate?
Radio Pipe Smoker of the Year, 1974.
Radio Pipe Smoker of the Year, 1974. Well, that truly is a lungmongously tobacco-tastic award. One of great and lasting significance in these non-smoking times.
Thanks, mate, but I really wish that you got it, not me.
So, we are Sir Mike Smash OBE saying, ta-da, minions, I'll leave you with old Nicey here and dusting the cobwebs off his pipe smoker award. See ya.
Oh, get knighted, Smashy. Right, this is a down-to-earth, honest-to-goodness, plain old Dave Nice, Radio Pipe Smoker of the Year 74, and Personality 92, saying, if you're listening in, Your Majesty, because I know you're a big fan of his show and guitar-based rock in general, spare an award for these three guys. They really deserve one. Barkman Turner and OBE Verdrive, your HC. You ain't got your knighthoods yet, mates, but I'm sure they're in the post. Arise, ye rockers.
Hello, Pixie.
Hello, Puppy.
Love my Pixie.
Love my Puppy too.
Love my Pixie more. Oh.
Sit by me, Puppy. Sit, Puppy. Sit by me.
Oh, Huggy. Oh, little one. I missed you so much when I was away.
Oh, I'm sorry I made you go away, but I was such a thirsty little Pixie. And did Daddy Chef put the chip-chips on?
Of course Daddy Chef popped the chip-chips on. And he thought about you every second he was doing it.
Did he, Honey Button? And what did he think of? Nice things?
He thought about how much he loved that folly bunny freckle on your little fairy face.
Oh, Pixie baby poodle. Oh. I don't want to watch the nasty television now that you're here. Switch it off. Don't leave me, Daddy Bunny.
But Mummy Bunny wants Daddy Bunny to turn the television off, doesn't Mummy Bunny?
Can't Mummy Bunny come with you?
Does Mummy Bunny want to come with me? What's Mummy Bunny saying? Daddy Bunny can't hear Mummy Bunny. Oh, of course Mummy Bunny can come. We'll go together.
I tried ringing you, mate. Your kitchen's belching out a ton of smoke.
Nasty, noisy man Dan shouted in Tiny Pixie's ears.
Daddy Bunny will shut nasty man in kitchen.
Yeah, well, mate.
Wayneta, there's someone at the bleeding door.
I'm in the kitchen.
So what?
I am stuck to the floor.
Well, I told you to give it a mop. Hurry up or she'll go away.
You answer it.
Oh, bloody hell. It's bloody Miles. Yeah?
Hello, I'm Janet Cornhill, your social worker.
So what?
I've come to assess little Frog Mellor.
Oh, do you want to come in then?
Yes, please.
Well, take your shoes off. You're getting filthy in here. Excuse the mess, honey. We can't be asked to clear up. Wayneta! It's a stupid social worker.
All right, I'm coming. Well, I got stuck to the floor. Right, well, as I was saying to your husband, I'm here for your daughter's routine assessment. Right. A cup of tea. Oh, yes. She'll be worried right some way. There you go. Thank you. Okay. How is she generally? Any medical problems?
Not really. Bit of a smoker's cough, that's all.
Has she started building with bricks yet?
Well, she's done a pretty good job on the kitchen extension, yeah.
Right. Well, perhaps I could see her.
Oh, right. There's Mummy's little baby then, eh?
Oh. She's grown, hasn't she?
Yeah, well, she's got a healthy appetite, just like her mum.
Right. Well, a couple of little tests. Mrs. Slob? Mrs. Slob? She doesn't seem to be focusing very well.
Yeah, well, nor would you after half a bottle of scotch.
You've not been giving her alcohol.
Oh, of course not. She nicks it.
Well, perhaps you shouldn't have hard liquor in the house.
No, she nicks it for lofi day in her life.
I really think this is not a very suitable environment for a child.
Well, it's her fault. She's a slob.
You're the slob?
You're the slob? Every time I go for a piss, the sink's full of washing up. And you never over the carpet.
How can I over it? I ain't seen it in 3 years.
Good point. Blimey. Either Frog Mellor needs her nappy changed or you've just dropped one.
Can you change her, please? Only he won't do it. I want to watch home and away.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to take this child into care.
Oh, good.
Thanks very much. Turn it on.
No, you turn it on.
You turn it on.
It's your turn.
Your turn.
It's not.
It's your turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. All right, lover. Did you get her purse? Who's a beauty then?
There you go. Now, do you want your dummy? All right.
What you drinking then? Part of lager?
No thanks, mate. I'm off it at the moment.
Uh-huh.
Been drinking far too much recently, so I'm knocking it on the head for a month, as from today. So I'll just have a mineral water, thanks.
Mineral water? You sure?
Yep. Month off, prove I can do it. It's all a question of willpower, Lance.
All right, then. One mineral water, please.
Oh, go on, then. I'll have half.
Half a lager,
oh,
please.
Sod it. You twisted me arm. Go on, make it a pint.
2 pints of lager, please, Dave.
Right.
One crisp.
No, thanks. I'm on a diet. Got to get rid of this.
Oh, they're very nice. That new flavour. Potato.
It's the principle, Lance.
Right, then. Fag?
No, thanks. I've given up.
Oh, no, they're very nice. Smoke flavour.
No, Lance, you can't tempt me. As from today, I'm a non-smoker. I mean, do you realise that every cigarette you have takes 5 minutes off your life? What are they, silk cut? Go on, gives a drag, then. I mean, silk cut ain't proper fags, are they? And 20 Bensons, please, Dave, and a packet of crisps. I'll have a bit of a chaser to go with a pint and some nuts and some pork scratches.
Is there anything else that you've given up? Just yep. So as I know.
Yep, gambling.
Never.
Yep, no more gambling.
You won't last 2 days.
Fiver says I will.
Cheers. I don't know where you get your tremendous willpower from, Lee.
Well, I got this book, haven't I?
Oh, yeah, what's that then?
It's called Learn Yourself Willpower, 1001 Ways to Get Things Done.
Is it any good?
Don't know, I haven't got round to starting it yet.
Here, look, there's that Maria over there. Are you still after her?
No, I'm not interested, Lance. I'm happy with my Alison. My wild days are over. I'm a changed man.
Right, do you mind if I have a crack at her then? Cheers. Hello, Maria. Lee's given up women, so I was wondering if you fancied having a snog with me.
I was just going home, actually, Lance.
Can I come? Go on, I ain't gonna try anything. I just, you know, thought I'd walk you home.
Look, right, as long as that's all.
Great, I'll go and get some condoms.
Oh, look, mate, there's Tony Crab. Remember his breakfast show, Crab in the Morning?
Certainly do, mate, but I always prefer the Crab in the Afternoon. Oh, look, it's Noel Tidybeard. And there's the granddaddy of them all, Sir Jimmy Savlon.
Oh, look, there's BLT, the hairy sandwich.
And look, there's the world's youngest man, David Kidd Pension.
Great times.
Great days.
Great guys.
Hi, guys, sorry to keep you waiting.
Hello, controller.
That's all right, sir.
Now, as you know, that's... Radio Fab's going through something of a facelift at the moment.
FM?
Pardon?
Radio Fab FM, sir.
Quite. Thank you, Fatberg.
Lovely to see you, mate.
Now, listen, boys, as you know, you've been with us now for years, and I like to think of you as part of the furniture here.
Sir? We like to think of ourselves as part of the furniture.
It's a great honour to be thought of as furniture, sir.
Of course, as you know, it's good sometimes to just move the furniture around a bit, isn't it?
I know what you mean, sir. I had to move me telly the other day. The sun was just a sort of a catch in the screen, and I couldn't see old Nicey here doing the pops. It really is important to move furniture around sometimes.
Objectastically wise words, mate, in a Chippendale Mungus type way.
Thanks, mate, because you really should move furniture.
Yeah, so talking of which, I've been thinking of moving you two.
Sir! Do I hear the snap, crackle and rock of people eating their brekkie while we're on air?
No, it's more like the clink, clink of people stirring their Horlicks.
You don't mean...
It can't be.
Not...
Radio quiet.
I think you two will be just the ticket for the radio quiet a mumbling around midnight spot.
No, sir. You can't promote us upstairs to radio quiet. Not with Doddery Dudley Doddington.
Gloria Funny Farm.
Jimmy Old.
I'm quite literally flabbergasted.
I'm phenomenally gobsmacked, sir. What about our old show? Who could you possibly find to replace us?
Raw young talent, Dave. Fresh off the streets. In fact, I think they should be on now.
Cowabunga! It's me, Mark Fadier here. That was the megatastic sound of Phil Collins there. Well, anyway, I think it's about time to go over now to me old mate Simon Christ. How you doing? Did you have a megatastic weekend? Best petitious, dude.
Weekend with an old friend of mine in my bark and bungalow in Portland Wood. Can I tell you all about it after I played this, one of my all-time favourite records of all time? These three guys will keep you popping. Mr. Tom, Mr. Robinson and Mr. Bad, TRB, are on the 2468 motorway. Let's hope it's not the M25, it's bumper to bumper.
Well, BBC Two is closing down now, but if you're a night bird, don't forget that Radio Quiet is on air all through the night to keep you company through the wee small hours.
Hello, Whispering Mike Smash here.
And a bumbling Sir Dave Nice. And a big hello to all you truckers out there.
Bonkers, isn't he? In a sleepy sort of way. And we're here to guide you through the night with some of the very best in adult-orientated, mega, middle-of-the-road mungus, light country jazz sounds.
And a big hello there to all you truckers.
So, if you, which you probably don't...
Big hello to all you truckers out there.
And don't forget, coming up at 2:30, our big, big quiz, Where's My Pencil?
It's in your pocket, mate. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, listeners. I blew everything. Well, here's something to help you drown the sorrows of the night. It's Colin Butterworth and the Radio Quiet Light Orchestra with Haven't Seen Anything Yet. Let's sob.